Let's store the clusters or groups that we just discovered in our whiskey data frame. Let's also rename the indices to match the sorting. We can accomplish this operation in three lines of code. We first extract the group labels from the model and append them to the whiskey table. We also specify their index explicitly. This is our first line of code. We then reorder the rows in increasing order by group labels. These are the group labels that we discovered using spectral co-clustering. Finally, we reset the index of our data frame. We have now reshuffled the rows and columns of the table, so let's also recalculate the correlation matrix. We will also turn the correlation matrix into a NumPy array. We're dealing with the whiskey data frame still. We first use the iLog. We're taking all of the rows, and then we'd like to specify columns from 2 to 14. We need to transpose this table as before, and to calculate correlations, we'll use pd.dataframe.core. Finally, I'm going to call this correlations. Let's then turn this into a NumPy array. We can just call that correlation. So correlations equals NumPy array correlations. The reason for this step is that when we calculate the correlations, what pandas returns is a data frame. What I would like to have is a NumPy array, hence the conversion. Let's then make a plot of the original correlation coefficients and the rearranged correlation coefficients, which we would expect to form clusters. Let's use the pcolor function to plot the two correlation matrices. Our original correlation matrix was called core underscore whiskey, and the new ordered correlation matrix is called correlations. This code is very similar to the code that we've already seen before. We can just run the code. And then we can find our file on the computer. And here we have our plot. So on the left, we have the original correlation matrix. Here we have 86 whiskies, and the correlation coefficients are computed over their flavor profiles. On the right, we have the exact same correlation matrix, except its rows and columns have been reordered. We asked the spectral co-clustering method to identify 6 different groups of whiskies. If you follow the diagonal line on the right, from the bottom left corner, the top right corner, you'll be able to see visually those 6 blocks of whiskies. Based on this, we would expect whiskies that belong to the same block to be similar in their flavor, in terms of their smokiness, in terms of their honey flavor, and so on. This is the end of the film segments of this case study. We have prepared additional exercises for you to continue working on the case. I hope you enjoyed the case study on Scotch whiskey.